All right, so far we learned how we can insert records inside a SharePoint list. Pretty much if you're following the same logic, if you want to add records to like even an Excel sheet or SQL database or anything else, all these actions work almost the same. But after we insert the record inside a SharePoint list or any other container, now we want to retrieve them, if we want to get them back. Now, there are three different approaches that we can take to get the content that we already put there, or maybe someone else put there, or different process added that to the SharePoint list in this example. One way is to get all of them, and then we process them one by one. The other way is to query a subset of them. For example, give me all the products in electronics category, or give me all the products that their unit price is above $100. Things like that have a different mechanism. So basically, we are using a different style of getting the content. Third way is we exactly know which item we want, and we point to that specific instance of the data by ID. Just like, I want that one. So in this case, we really don't search, we really don't query. Power Automate engine goes straight to that record and returns it back to us. Now, let's see each one of those examples and how we can handle those situations. We start with getting all the items, which is the easiest example. All right, considering the complexities that we are going through for this chapter, I would like to create a new SharePoint list from scratch. And because I assume that you're following the instructions and you want to do what I do with me, I want to create everything right in front of you. So follow me, go to your SharePoint site, the site that you are the site owner, and start creating a new custom list. So we click on the settings and I click on add an app. And this app is going to be a custom list. So I give it a name and I say products list demo and I click on create. It's created. Products list demo is created. If I click on this one, as soon as the list created, we want to add more columns than just one title. I click on new column and I want to add a choice. So the name is going to be category of the product. And type is going to be choice. First one is going to be electronics. Second one is going to be toys. Third one is going to be gardening. And let me add another choice and I call it sports. And I click on save. After category, I want to add another one, which is going to be currency, and I call it unit price, and everything else, I just accept it. I'm good with that. And that's all about it. Let me just add a few items quickly. So the first item, I click on new. Product is going to be laptop. Category, electronics. Unit price is going to be $1,400. And that's it. Let me add another one. Microphone, and category again is going to be electronics, and unit price is going to be $140, and I click on save. Let me add another one, and here is my final list after adding a few more items. Now let's go back to Power Automate and see if it can create a flow that reads all these items into flow. To get the items, I go to flow.microsoft.com. As expected, and I click on create. I want to start a new flow from scratch. And this one, you guessed it, it's going to be an instant flow because that's the easiest we can get. And I call it get items from SharePoint. And I click on manually trigger a flow and I click on create. Now I have a button that when someone clicks on the button, it fires the flow. Now let's add the next step. So if we go under SharePoint, I click on SharePoint. So it gives me all the actions related to SharePoint. As you can see, the list is growing every day. So we need get items. Keep in mind that we have get items and get item. Get items reads a bunch of list items. Get item reads a specific list item. So we start with get items, we query with get items, but when we use get item, it gives us one specific record, which I told you, we point to that record and say, I want this one. At the moment, we are not going there. We start with get items because we want to get all the items from that list. To get there, just like before, we go and find the Power Automate workshop that I created or the site that you have. If you have it here, perfect. If you don't, just click on the enter custom value and you go back to your SharePoint site, take a copy of the URL and just paste it here. And SharePoint specific actions are smart enough that no matter what you give to them, it trims to the site URL. Just don't let this one spoil you, because when you're working with the other actions that you need to connect to a SharePoint site, you have to specifically provide the SharePoint site URL. Like for example, if you want to connect to an Excel file and that Excel file is in SharePoint, the URL that you need to provide has to be the trimmed URL of the site. But SharePoint actions are very forgiving in this sense. Now we need to pick up the list that we had. The list that we created is called products list demo. Let's see if we can pick it up from the list of lists. So I click on this dropdown. It's gonna be products list demo. I gladly pick it up and I'm all set. Now, let me add my next step, which is compose. And I click on my magical control, click on the input, and I get the value from the get items. So it should have the list of all the items that it returns in an array. Let's see how it looks, and then we customize it a little bit more. So let me click on test so we can run it. This is the first run. So I click on I'll perform a trigger action, and I click on test. It gives me the approval that are you sure you want to use this connection? Obviously, because this is the first time again that we are calling this flow, I click on continue, run flow, and done. Let's see the result. If I click on compose, it's nothing pleasant to eyes, especially if you're not familiar with JSON or JavaScript object notation. But it returned us an array that has every single item. First item is a laptop. The category is electronics. The unit price is $1,400, and so on and so forth. So you can go through every single item. Fantastic. But what can we do with this? Let's see how we can navigate through the items that the get items returns and do something with it. So again, I click on edit. I don't need this compose anymore. Let's do something useful with that. Let me create an email that contains the product title. Send email. So I will use the send email v2. And I want to send it to myself. Let's say product list. And for the body of the email, I want to put the title. Just pay attention what happens when I click on title. Something appears around this record called apply to each. So basically, as soon as I add the title of the item to the email, Power Automate Engine is smart enough to understand that title is not just one title, because get item returns an array of titles. So to go through every single one of them, we are using an action called apply to each. I will go through it in details in the future chapters. For now, just consider it as a control that encloses every single item that is returned as an array or as a list of items. So I have title, comma. I can add category here, for example, category value. Let me go to the next one and I click on maybe unit price. Unit price, I just click on it and I add it here. You can make it look a little bit better. Product name. Category. And finally, the last line is going to be unit price. And I click on save. So this is what happens. Apply to each runs whatever that is inside it for every single item of these product items. So we expect to receive one email per item in the list. A little bit scary, especially if the list is quite big, but let's give it a shot and see how it works. Let me just save it. I open my mailbox quickly. So this is the last item that I have in the list. I go back to my Power Automate and let's test this one and see what we get. I click on continue, run flow, done. It's complete. Now let's go back to the mailbox and see what we got. Laptop, we got microphone, tennis ball sport, Rubik's Cube toys. So long story short, we get one email for every single product. You may want to compile everything to one list, which we will get there later. But at the moment, we successfully read every single item in a list using getItems and using a loop called apply to each. We could navigate through every single item. So we successfully got all the items using getItems. Now let's see how we can get a subset of data. For example, every product that is more than $100.